I wanted to go farther west and get so far away we don't get any of that severe weather here. But there's really no way that that's going to happen. Even though it's inch farther to the west, it still doesn't make me optimistic or happy. I just can't be that way because here's the eye taking its dear sweet time leaving Cuba. And so if you were over here on this part of Cuba, which is about as close as it's going to come to downtown Orlando, you're still getting huge, catastrophic winds, awful rains, and just a pummeling like you've never seen before. This is what it looks like right now. The storm is taking its dear sweet time leaving Cuba. Let me step to this side. Here's the update of the position. Winds are down to 120 miles per hour. Look at the movement. It's just about gone stationary. It's moving northwest now at only 6 miles per hour. Pressure steady at 933 millibars. Here's the track that you want to see. They've jogged it farther to the west, still making landfall over here, nipping at the coastal zones of Florida and pulling it farther away, still peeling right over Tampa Bay and then out over here, right around the Big Bend area, as a Category 1 by Monday morning at 8 a.m. with 90-mile-per-hour winds before jetting on up into the Tennessee Valley. So the truth of the matter is, we're still in the cone of projected movement in the western side of the viewing area, but it looks more and more likely like the eye will not come in here, but the impacts will still be extreme in a large part of Central Florida. So for now, a little bit of improvement, if you will, if you believe that going farther west is going to help it. I'm not so sure that's really going to help it much with the impacts that we're going to have. But anytime it goes farther and farther away, this helps the east coast of Florida a little bit as time goes on. Yes, Matt, you got a question?
I just have a question for you, Tom. At 6 miles an hour, does that freak you out a little bit, or is it
going to
speed up?
It does, because it freaks me out to know, I wonder if it's really going to keep trucking on the path. Mm-hmm. The only good side of this is that the models are back in agreement still. We knew it about an hour and a half ago, maybe 2 hours ago, when the new model runs finally updated, that they had jogged farther to the west. They're in agreement in pulling it west. They've been inching west, inching west, inching west, inching west all along in the last 48 hours. So the Hurricane Center is following them, but not overcorrecting. So I would love it if it went all the way out here. If it went all the way out here and we get nothing but tropical storm force winds in our area, that'd be a blessing from God. So keep praying and hoping. But I just don't see that happening. We'll keep you posted. Back to you guys.
And Tom, one more thing. The fact that it is going 6 miles per hour, does that concern you that it's going to then be over those warm waters,
right,
allowing it to intensify?
Well, they've downgraded the strength of the system because the winds have dived down to 120. Instead of bringing it back to a 4 status or a 5, they keep it at a 3. But as I reiterate time and time again, we do great with the track once it gets to going. But when the storm is stationary, and it's not totally stationary, but when a storm goes stationary, scares the daylights out of me because you really don't know where it's going.
Mm-hmm. All right. Chief Meteorologist Tom Swirls with the 11 o'clock update there. Thank you.